Hello students, welcome back to Programming in C Language. Myself Srikanth. So we are discussing computer fundamentals memory topic. So on that, we discussed in detail in the previous session about registers, cache memory, main memory, magnetic disk and magnetic tape. So we discussed in detail about internal memories, primary memory. We are on secondary memory. We are discussing about what? Secondary memory. Okay, so this is about secondary memories like magnetic, optical and solid state storages. So we are discussed in the previous session in detail about what is secondary storage, what is SAM, sequential access memory, what is DAM, direct access memory, and what is magnetic storage. And it consists of different types of magnetic storage like magnetic tape, magnetic disk, cartridge tape and zip drive. See, on that we discussed in detail about what magnetic tape and its features. Magnetic disk, that to be what? Floppy disk or removable disk, hard disk are also called fixed disk. So in detail I explained about what floppy disk. Also I given some introduction about what hard disk in the previous session video. So if you missed the previous session video, I given the link in the description box. Kindly go through that link. I covered all these before the topics what I explained now. Okay, see, now we'll start with again with what? Hard disk. See, what is this hard disk? Hard disk is another type of what? Magnetic disk, on which we can store data and information what? Permanently. See, who has invented this hard disk? IBM in the year what? 1957. See, the first production IBM hard disk drive, the 350 disk storage in the around 1957, they are going to be initiated. First hard disk, that is done by what? IBM. See, it consists different components of the IBM, like 305 Ramka systems, IBM 350 were the IBM 355, IBM 7300, IBM 1405, like various versions. They are going to be enhanced with this what? Hard disk, used in what? Hard disk. See, a hard disk contains what? Number of what? Platters of aluminium coated with magnetic material. So each of these platters is divided into what? Tracks and sectors. So this is about what? Platters. So we can able to see this is about what? Platter. These are all consists what? Platters, we may call it. Okay, so within the platter, again they are categorized by what? It consists what? Tracks. Within the tracks, they are categorized by what? Sectors. Okay, yeah, I will explain, don't worry. See, it is divided into what? Tracks and sectors. All the platters are arranged on a spindle. This spindle is attached to a what? Monitor that can rotate at a speed of what? 5600 rotation per minute, or 7200 RPM rotation per minute. See, all these platters are going to be connected with what? One spindle. This is spindle. So this spindle is going to be what? This spindle is what? Attached to a what? One motor that can rotate at a speed of what? 5600 rotation per minute RPM, or 7200 RPM rotation per minute. Okay, yeah. See, the some characteristics we had discussed previously. This hard disk holds what? More data than what? Floppy disk. See, its storage capacity is what? Generally in the form of what? Gigabytes, terabytes, like that. See, in the market it is available what? Terabytes, gigabytes and terabytes, both the sizes are available in the market. Okay, see, this is what? Non-volatile storage device. The data stored, data instructions, informations are stored what? Permanently. The stored data on hard disk should be what? Formatted. So yesterday only explained. See, before storing the data in the hard disk, the data that hard disk should be what? Formatted. See, formatted is nothing but what? Is a process of what? Creating a tracks and sectors on the surface of what? Hard disk, so that the data can be stored. Okay, you can able to see. So this is what platter. In the platter, once you are formatted, it's going to be created for several tracks, within that sectors. Using this only we can able to store what? Data. Tracks are concentric circles and sectors are the portions created by dividing the disk into the number of portions. See, this is about what? Tracks. Tracks are what? Concentric circles. So try to observe here. So this is about what? Track. Okay, track 1, track 2, track 3, like it's going to be created what? N number of tracks within a platter. Okay, track 1, track 2, track 3, so on, track N it's going to be created. See, tracks are nothing but what? Concentric circles. See, this is about what? Concentric circles. What is sectors? Sectors are nothing but what? Portions created by dividing the disk into what? Number of portions. So this is about what? Sector. This is one sector. So this is another sector. This is another sector. Like that, it's going to be create what? Within a track, multiple sectors are going to be created. So this portion is called what? We can call it what? Sectors we may call it. Okay. Like that, every track consists what? It's going to be created what? Sectors. Okay, so that's what I told. Sectors are the what? Portions created by dividing the disk into what? Number of portions. See, these number of portions are clubbed. We can call it what? Clusters. Okay, so this is about what? Tracks and sectors. I hope everyone is clear, right? Say, so I try to take another one like that. So this is about what? Track. Okay, so I choose another colors like, so this is about what? Tracks. So within the platter, it's going to be generated what? Number of tracks like that. Okay. So each track, again, it is going to be partitioned into what? So each track, it's going to be portioned. That is called what? Sectors. So this portion is called what? Sectors. This portion is called what? Sectors. This portion is called sectors. Combining these number of sectors, those portions are called what? Clusters. See, hard disk are enclosed in a sealed container. Okay. See how this hard disk is going to be enclosed? Say, observe here. That hard disk is going to be enclosed in what? Sealed container. The hard disk is a non-removable form of storage device in olden days. But nowadays, removable hard disk, like external hard disk, is also available. See, just like pen drives, how we are using exactly like that, external hard disk is also available in the market, up to terabytes. See, hard disk are what? More reliable than what? Floppy disk, because they are generally fitted inside the cabinet of the computer, internal hard disk. So they remain protected from what? External environment factors like dust, temperature, and so on. Okay. See, these hard disks generally, this is internal hard disk generally connected with what? The cabinet of the particular system. See why? Because it avoids what? Like it's going to be protecting what? Like dust, temperature, moistures, and so on. Okay. Hard disk are what? More faster than what? Floppy disk. Hard disk are what? Less portable than the floppies, because it is fixed. But nowadays, external hard disk came, that is portable in nature. Okay. See, hard disk generally offer what? Quicker access to data than what? Floppy disk. Hard disk offers what? Very low cost of data storage. See, we can purchase like 1 terabyte hard disk from around 4,000 to 5,000 rupees. You may purchase like 1 TB hard disk. We can store huge volume of data, 1 TB, 2 TB, like that. It is available in the market. See, a hard drive needs to be what? Periodically defragmented, where the computer reorganizes all of what is written on the drive surface for optimized performance. Okay, see, observe, I try to explain some internal structure of what these are, internal component of what? Hard disk drive. See, you can able to see here, this is about what? Cover mounting holes. Cover not shown. Okay, cover mounting holes we can call it. So this is about what? Case mounting holes. You can able to see, this is about what? Case mounting holes. Next, platters. See, this is about what I told you, just platter, number of disk. You can able to see, like this is platter 1, platter 2, platter. This is all called, we can call platters. Okay, yeah, about platter. Next, ribbon cable, attached heads, logical boards. So this is about what? Ribbon cable. See, next, tape seal, power connector. Here we are going to, here the power is there, power connector, jumper pins. Okay, SCSI interface connector. See, actuators. So this is what? Activator. You can able to observe here, the activator consists what? The up and down, both it going to be reads the data. Generally, this activator is used for what? Read or write arm with what? Head. See, this is about what? Arm we can call it. See, this is about what? Read or write head we can call it. Once it is touched to the particular track of the sector, it's going to be reads the data or writes the data to the particular platter. Okay, so that is about what actuator. So actuator axis, it going to be used, this actuator axis, like it going to be rotates like that, it going to be rotates like that. Okay, actuator axis. Actuator arm, this is about actuator arm. Next is slider and head, we can call it, it is about what slider or head. Okay, this is what spindle, you can able to see. This is what spindle. A spindle consists what plotters, number of plotters are there within the spindle. Next, base casting. So this is about what internal component of what hard disk drive. But you try to understand here how it is functioning. So this is about platter. A platter consists what number of tracks. Okay, try to concentrate here. So I try to explain here. This platter consists what, like number of tracks like that. Okay. This is about what tracks, we can call it in a platter, within the platter only it is there, but it came outside, no issue. See, observe, this is about what sectors. Okay, this is about what sector, like that. Okay, so this is about what sectors, these small portions are called, we can call it is what sectors, we may call it. Okay, see what this actuator is going to be doing. That actuator is going to be touch this track sector, then what happens, which is used for what, read or write head. This portion is called head, read or write head. See this one, we can call it is what arm. Okay, this is called what arm. So it is going to be there in up and down, both there it going to be read or write with the platter track sectors. This number of sectors, grouped sectors, we can call it is what clusters. Okay, this is the way it's going to be what functioning of platter. Okay, so you can able to see detail. This is about track 1, track 2, track 3, so on, track n. These are all called track, we may call it. See what is cluster. See, this is about what cluster, the number of sectors, group of sectors, we can call it what clusters. So this is about what sector, sector 1, sector, like these are all called different types of sectors. So spindle is nothing but what, this represents what spindle. Here you can able to see, see this one represents what spindle. Say actuator is going to be, it going to be touches that head to the particular track on sector, then it going to be perform what read or write operations of the particular platter. So this is the way the hard disk is going to be working. See, it's going to be nearly 5200 to 7000 RPM. Okay, rotation per minute is going to be that is going to be functioning. Okay, see, a motor that can rotate at a speed of what 5600 rotation per minute RPM or 7200 RPM. Okay, so this is the functioning of hard disk. This is about internal components of hard disk. This is about what structure of what platters. See here in detail of disk stack, spindle and motor, disk drive assembly. Okay, electronic board, electronic on flex, actuator. This actuator consists of the fast movements, like this is a fast movement of what head, read or write head arm. It's going to be keep on rotating like this. Okay, on top and bottom of particular platter. See head gimbal assembly plus integrated lead suspension. So this is about GMR element or pico slider. This is for woofer. So this is about what internal component of what hard disk drives and structure of what hard disk, how it is going to be functioning. Okay, yes, this is, that's fine about how it is going to be functioning. See, hard disk are connected to what system by standard interface cable, such as what PATA, parallel ATA, SATA, serial ATA, USB or SAS, serial attached SCSI cables. So the modern HDDs are around 3.5 inch for desktop computers and 2.5 inch what primarily for what laptops. Okay, so in the market both the internal and external hard disk are available. Okay, so up to here fair enough about what is hard disk, what is the features of hard disk, history of hard disk and functioning of the hard disk, internal component and the structure of hard disk, up to here more than enough. Okay, so next we go with the another next important type of tape called cartridge tape or cartridge tape, we may call it. Okay, see what is this cartridge tape. A data cartridge tape is a storage device that contains a spool of magnetic tape used to store different kinds of data, including what audio and video files. See, it's going to be looks like that. This is about cartridge tape. This is about what? Cartridge tape, like sound tape. Okay. See, each cartridge is designed to fit into a what? Compatible audio or video recorder system or computer systems. Okay. See, it is a magnetic tape storage. Cartridge used in what? Tape library units to store what? Digital data on what? Magnetic tape, which is packaged in what? Cassettes and cartridges. Tape libraries automatically load, unload, and store multiple tapes. Okay, increasing the volume of data which can be stored without manual interventions. See, it is used as a robust backup system. See, robustness, we may call it right, robust backup systems, which makes use of our tape libraries for long-term backup storage. See, it contrasts to magnetic tape. It has a favorable unit cost and a long actual stability. Okay, see, it is a cheaper for what? GB, gigabyte, compared to what? Hard drives and solid state drives, making it what? Ideal for what? Long term storage achieving. Okay, unlike a hard disk, it supports what? Sequential reading and writing. So if a specific file needs to be located, the tape drive must read the tape cartridge from the beginning of the spool until it reaches the specific file location. It is its biggest limitation. See, this is about what? Cartridge tape. Simply, it is cartridge tape is telling about what? It contains what? Spool of magnetic tape. Use it to store what? Different kinds of data, including what? Audio and video files. See, it used as what? Robust backup system, which makes what? Use of tape libraries for long-term backup storage. See, it supports what? Sequential reading and writing. Okay. See, the RCA tape cartridge is a magnetic tape audio format that was designed to offer what? Stereo quarter inch reel-to-reel tape recording quality in a convenient format for the consumer market. See, around when it is introduced around 1958. See, in current production are the cassette tape, the LTO tape cartridge, and the IBM 3592 tape cartridge. See, these are all what? Latest type of what? Cartridge. See, coming to audio, like cassette tape, a common cassette tape format for what? Analog audio recording and playback and introduced in around 1963. See, DAT, digital audio tape, a signal recording and playback medium developed by what? Sony, and introduced around what? 1987. See, digital compact cassette, DCC, a magnetic tape sound recording format introduced by what? Philips and Matoshitz in around late 1992 and marketed as a successor to the standard analog compact cassette. See, digital tape format, it is also a what? A magnetic tape data storage format developed by what? Sony. See, these are all the various companies are introduced by different types of audio types, like cassette tapes, digital audio tape, digital compact cassette, DCC, digital tape format. These are all what? Various types of different formats introduced by companies for audio purpose. And coming to video, like video cassette, a cartridge containing what? Video tape. Cartridge containing what? Video tape. VHS, the most successful format for what? Consumer level analog video recording on what? Tape cassette. Like Betamax, another common consumer video cassette format. U-matic, an earlier 3x4 inch video tape format, mostly for what? Professional use. See, these are all what? Various audio and video formats available in the market, released by what? Different companies. Okay, see, these computer data like DDS, digital data storage cassettes, like data 8 cassette, a video cassette derivative by what? Exabyte, digital linear tape cartridge DLT, IBM 7340 cartridge, one of the first tape format packaged in what? Cassette. See, another one called linear tape open cartridge LTO. See, these are all what? Various versions and advanced extensions of what? This cartridge tape. Okay, see, normally this cartridge tape is nothing but what? It contains a spool of magnetic tape used to store what? Different kinds of data, including specially for what? Audio and video files. So these are all called different types of audio formats and videos. Okay, so this is about what? Cartridge tape. So next, zip drive or zip disk. A zip drive and a zip disk is a removable floppy disk. Removable floppy disk storage system that was introduced by what? Lomiga in 1994. See, zip drive is going to be looks like that. See, what it is a removable floppy disk storage system introduced by what? Lomiga in the 1994. See, this is about what? Zip drive. See, it functions like a standard 1.44 floppy drive and a diskette, but its capability to hold by up to what? 100 MB of data or 250 MB of data makes it what? Unique. Okay, so zip disks were originally launched with what? Capacities of what? 100 MB, then 250 MB, and finally what? 750 MB. See, zip drives has a stronger plastic covering, making it easier to store and handle data. See, it is lightweight, portable, and reeled on what? Magnetic storage techniques. Zip drives are less vulnerable to damage and wear, much stronger and more durable. See, it is used to store, share, and backup large amount of data, which was not possible with what? Ordinary floppy disk. So it like a floppy diskette. The zip disk contains a magnetic circular disk that holds what? Information. To read and write information on a zip diskette. See, it is placed into a what? Zip drive that moves the metal cover, exposing the magnetic disk. Okay. See, in addition to data backup, zip disk can store and exchange what? Unusually large files, such as graphic images. See, with the introduction of better storage mediums such as like DVD rewriters, along with what? Higher capacity hard disk, the zip disk becomes what? Less favored, and eventually what? Disappeared from the market, because in the market high level things are already available, like a hard disk and like optical disks are there. Okay, see, this is about what? Zip drive or zip disk. See, today we discussed in detail about what? Different types of what? Secondary storage devices. Okay, see, in detail I explained the memory hierarchy. See, this is about what? Secondary memories. On that, we discussed about what? Magnetic disk. Okay, see, this is what? More access time, because it is far to the processor, that's what it access what? More access time. But comparatively what? Expensive. This is what? Cheap. Why? Because it is not there within the processor, not nearest to the processor. Okay, so it is externally we are going to be purchasing a magnetic disk. Next, the capacity wise, comparatively resistors, magnetic disk can store what? Large volume of data, huge volume of data. Okay, so coming to the computer memories, we discussed in detail in the primary storages about resistors and magnetic disk. See, the next coming sessions will discuss in detail about what? Optical disk and solid state storages. These two also comes under what? Secondary storages, but we'll discuss in the next coming sessions. So we discussed in detail in this session like magnetic disk, like magnetic tape and magnetic disk. In the magnetic disk, we discuss floppy disk, hard disk or fixed disk. In the magnetic tapes, like cartridge drives and cassette drives. Okay. See, what is a secondary storage? It is used to store what? Data permanently. It is non-volatile. It is slower than the main memory. Use it for what? Storing large volume of data. And we can able to store permanently these data and informations. Okay. See, these are all the important characteristics of secondary memory. We had discussed different types of secondary storages like magnetic storage, optical storage, and solid storage. But in this session, we discussed completed up to what? Magnetic storage. See, how this data is going to be managed. The data is going to be managed in the form of what? SAM and DAM. SAM is nothing but what? Sequential access memory. Here the data storage devices that read their data in what? Sequence manner. Sequence means what? Continuous manner. Okay, best examples like magnetic tape, audio or video cassettes. Okay, and coming to DAM, direct access memory is a form of what? Computerized data storage. Here directly stores and retrieves the data, but it is not in an ordered manner or sequenced manner. Best examples like magnetic disk and optical disk. I also provided some differences here in the previous session videos. Okay, coming to magnetic storage, we discussed in detail what is magnetic storage. It consists of what? Different patterns of what? Magnetization are used to what? Represent stored bits or bytes of information is called what? Magnetic storage. Basically, it consists of what? Magnetic tape, magnetic disk, cartridge tape and zip drives. Okay, in the magnetic tape we discussed like it is a storage system for what? Storing digital information of what? Magnetic tape using what? Digital recording. Okay, so it generally is used for what? Backup of data. See, several real-time releases are there. IBM system 360, like 1964, around 1964 they used 9-track tape, linear tape open, LTO, like IBM 3592 series of what? Tape drivers. These are all what used in the particular systems. Okay, for used for what? High speed applications. Internally it is used for what? Mylar material. Okay, generally it is stored in the form of what? Binary digits, zeros and ones representations. And also we discussed about what? Magnetic disk. It's like what? Gramophone record, which is made up of what? Plastic like same material called mylar. Okay, it basically categorized again two types. One is called floppy disk or removable disk, another called hard disk or what? Fixed disk. So in case of floppy disk, we discussed in detail or read for what? Read from the return to by what? Floppy disk drives, FDD. Using this FDD, we can able to store the information, read the information from floppy. See, it was introduced by IBM around 1970s, 1972, like that. See, it consists of what? Round, flat piece of what? Plastic coated with what? Magnetic material. See, the size of the dimension of floppy disk core varies. 3.5 inches, it can store what? 1.44 MB data. And 5.25 inches, it store 1.2 MB data. So it is very big thing when it going to be read and write the data in 1970s. But nowadays, we are storing what? Large volume of data in the form of what? Terabytes, gigabytes, petabytes, exabyte, zettabyte, like we can store huge volume of data. But in around 1970s, it is very big thing to store what? 1.44 MB data. That to be what? These floppy is what? Portability. Okay, it is portable. We can carry anywhere. Okay, so this is what, but some limitations are there. It can use only 3 to 4 times only. Okay, and it is sensitive what? To the dust, temperature, moisture and other environmental factors. See, next is what? Hard disk or fixed disk. See, the name came for fixed disk. Initially kept the name called fixed disk. Later it was renamed by what? Hard disk. Why the name kept for fixed disk? Because it is internally attached to the cabinet of the system. That's what they kept what? Fixed disk. See, it can store what? Data and information what? Permanently. That to be what? Not limited amount of data. We can store what? Huge volume of data. In the market, you can able to see available like 1 TB, 2 TB hard disk. That to be internal hard disk as well as what? External hard disk. Internal means what? It is fixed. But in external hard disk means we can portable from one place to another place like that. Okay. So it is non-volatile storage. Once the data stored in the hard disk, the data is going to be stored what? Permanently. Okay. See, a hard disk contains what? It consists what? Number of platters of aluminium coated with what? Magnetic material. The diagrammatically explained about this is about what? Platters. See, this is platters. It is what? There within the spindle. See, with each platter consists what? Tracks, like track 1, track 2, track 3, so on, track N. Each track again portioned with what? Some portion is called sectors, we may call it. See, this is going to be read and write operation head by what? Actuators. This is called upper surface and the below or lower surface of the particular platter. See, it going to be touches this actuator, read and write. Using this actuator, we can able to read and write done with these platters. Okay, see, it going to be rotations with the different types of speeds. See, this group of sectors, we may call it what? Clusters. Okay, so this is a basic functioning about what? Hard disk. The highest capacity hard disk in the 2019, around 2019, is what? 16 terabytes. See, the modern hard disk like 3.5 inches for desktop computers and 2.5 inches for what? Primarily for what? Laptops. See, these HDDs are connected to what? System by standard interface cables like PATA, parallel ATA, SATA, serial ATA, okay, ATA, SATA, simply we can call it, right? Like SATA, we can call it USB or SAS, serial attached SCSI cables, okay. Next, its storage capacity ranges from what? GB to TB. In the 2019 up to 2019, 16 terabytes, okay, maximum. It stores what data? Permanently. See, the coming to history, the first production IBM hard disk drive, what? The 350 disk storage is shipped in what? 1957 as a component of what? IBM 305 Ramka systems. IBM 350 were the IBM 355, IBM 7300 and IBM 1405. There it going to be used for these hard disks. Okay. So this is what internal components of hard disk and structure of the hard disk, like platters, actuators, sectors, okay, and spindle. And this is about what? How it is going to be rotating. So explain in detail about what the component and structure of hard disk. And also we discussed about what these cartridge tapes. It contains what? Spool of magnetic tape used to store what? Different kinds of data, including what? Audio and video files. Okay. See, the various audio formats like cassette tapes, DAT, digital audio tape, DCC, digital compact cassettes, DTF, like digital tape formats. These are all various audio formats released by different companies, like Sony is there, Philips is there, and so on, right? Coming to video, like video cassettes are cartridge containing what? Video tapes, like VHS, Betamax, U-matic, like these are all the various different formats of what? Videos. See, coming to history, like various computer datas like DDS, digital data storage cassettes, data 8 cassettes, video cassette derived by what? Exabytes, digital linear tape cartridge DLT, IBM 7340 cartridge, one of the first tape format packed in what? Cassette, linear tape open cartridge LTO, like these are all what? Various different formats of what? Cartridge tapes. Okay, see, it is used for what? Different kinds of data, including what? Audio and video files. Okay, it's going to be looks like this. Next, we had discussed about zip drive or zip disk. See, this is what? It is a removable floppy disk storage system that was introduced by what? Lumega in late 1994. So it is also stores what? It has what? Strong plastic covering, make it easier to store and handle data. Okay. So these are all what? Various magnetic disk we discussed in detail. Okay. See. Thank you for watching my videos. If you like my videos, kindly like, and if you're not subscribed, kindly subscribe it for getting more updates of the computer fundamentals and programming in C language. Thank you all.